गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, हाउ आर यू? टुडे आई एम हियर विथ बायोलॉजिकल क्लासिफिकेशन पार्ट टू ऑफ 11th स्टैंडर्ड। हियर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस किंगडम प्रोटिस्टा। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द इम्पॉर्टेंट फीचर्स ऑफ प्रोटिस्टा। प्रोटिस्टा आर सिंगल सेल यूकैरियोट्स हैविंग वेल डिफाइंड न्यूक्लियस एंड मेम्ब्रेन बाउंड ऑर्गेनल्स which was absent in Monera. They are mostly aquatic and this kingdom forms a link with the other kingdom like plants, animals and fungi. They have locomotory organelles in the form of either cilia or flagella. Reproduction in protista is either asexual or sexual by cell fusion and zygote formation. There are different types of protists and they are chrysophytes, dinoflagellates, euglenoids, slime molds and protozoan. Here you can observe different members of euglena, dinoflagellate, paramecium, diatom and macroalgae. Okay, now let us see about different types of protista. First is chrysophytes. Chrysophytes includes diatom and golden algae, that is desmids. They are present in both fresh and marine water. They are microscopic, means very small, and plankton, means present on the surface of water. Mostly they are photosynthetic. In diatoms, the cell wall forms two thin overlapping cells that fit together as in soap box. The walls of the diatoms are embedded with silica, so walls are indestructible. They are not destructible, and it leaves large amount of cell deposit when they are present. They leave that cell deposits. Diatoms are chief producer in the oceans. When the diatom leaves large amount of silica on the earth, it is called as diatomaceous earth, and they are used in polish making, filtration of oil and syrups. In this figure you can observe diatoms, and here it is the golden algae. Now it is about next group of protists, that is dinoflagellates, means members having two flagella, as the name indicates. They are mostly marine and photosynthetic and are of different colors like yellow, green, brown, blue or red, depending upon the type of pigments present in their cell. Cellulose is present on the outer surface of cell wall. As the name indicates, previously I have told you that dinoflagellate, most of them have two flagella. One lies longitudinally, another transversally in a furrow between the wall plates. Due to excessive growth of a red dinoflagellate, that is the name is Goniolex, the sea appears red and it is called as red tides. So due to the presence of large amount or large growth, heavy growth, excessive growth of Goniolex, it is a red dinoflagellate, the sea appears red in color. And this appearance of red color due to this organism, it is called as red tides. And whenever they grow vigorously, then a toxic is released by them. And these toxic substances may kill marine fishes. Here you can observe the different dinoflagellate members and growth of dinoflagellates which appears the sea red in color. Next group of protista is euglenoid, which are mostly present in fresh stagnant water. Member of euglenoids have no cell wall and there is presence of a protein rich layer, and that protein rich layer is called as pellicle. Here cell wall is not present, but a protein rich layer is present, and that protein rich layer is called as pellicle, and this pellicle makes their body flexible. They also have two unequal size flagella and are photosynthetic, having photosynthetic pigments, but in absence of sunlight they behaves as heterotrophs and depends on other smaller organisms for food. If the sunlight is present, then they behaves as photosynthetic, means autotrophic, but when the sunlight is not present, then they behaves as heterotrophs, and at that time they depends on other smaller organisms for food. Common example of euglenoid is Euglena. Here you may observe different euglenoids. Next is about slime mold, which are saprophytic, means they grow along with decaying twigs and leaves and consume organic matter present in them, means they derive their nutrition from decaying twigs and leaves. Under suitable conditions, they form an aggregation, and at that time they called plasmodium, which may grow and spread over several feet. During unfavorable situation, plasmodium differentiate and form fruiting bodies that bear spores at their tips. These spores have two walls and resistant, so they survive for many years. Spores are further dispersed by air current. Here you can see the growth of slime mold and fruiting body. Last category of protista is protozoan. They are also heterotrophs, predators or parasites. Protozoans are considered as primitive relative of animals and are classified into four major groups. How many? Four major groups. So we will discuss one by one. First among them is amoeboid protozoan. So let us study about amoeboid protozoan. They are present in fresh water, sea water, or on moist soil. They have pseudopodia, that is fast foot, to capture food and also for locomotion. Marine forms of amoeboid protozoan have silica cells on their surface. Some are parasites like Inta amoeba histolytica, and they causing diseases to human being. The common disease is amoebic dysentery, that is occurring in case of human being. You may observe here Inta amoeba histolytica, a parasite forms of amoeboid protozoan. Second protozoan is flagellated protozoan, means they have flagella. And they are also either free living or parasites, and parasitic forms causes diseases like sleeping sickness, and it is caused by Trypanosoma. It is a flagellated protozoan and the name is Trypanosoma that causes the sleeping sickness. Third protozoan is ciliated protozoan. They are aquatic, having thousands of cilia that are locomotory organelles. They have presence of cavity called as gullet that opens to the outside of the cell surface, and Cilia helps in capturing the food also. Common example of ciliated protozoan is paramecium. What is paramecium? Here it is the Trypanosoma brucei that causes diseases, sleeping sickness. You may see here paramecium also. You can observe thousands of cilia are present around the whole body surface. That helps in capturing the food and also locomotion. Now the last group of protozoans are sporozoans. These have infectious spores like stays in their life cycle. Common example is Plasmodium, called as malarial parasites that causes malaria. You may observe here Plasmodium. Here it is the sporozoa having internal structure. So this is children for today's session. Thank you, and for any kind of doubts, please write your questions in comment section.